What is up, guys? Welcome back to Comic Books vs. the World. And before I get into this video, I just want to give a quick shout out to my main man, Sketchy. He's the guy who made the brand new intro you just saw a second ago. He makes high quality intros like that one all the time, and they take a ton of time and work to make. So if you guys want to show some love for the new intro, maybe you want to see some of the other types of intros he's made, then go ahead and sub to his channel. You can click the link either on screen or in the description. Check out some of the other intros he's made in the past. Come on, let's help him reach 2,000 subs. Show him how much you guys love the new intro. Anyways, I don't know if you all know about this, but the new Power Rangers movie is coming out in the US next Friday. You'd think the studio would want to make it a little bit clearer that the movie's coming out, since I don't think I would have been able to figure it out after seeing the trailers, TV spots, ads, and toys coming out. Nope, not at all. But anyways, the movie's coming out soon, and Bleeding Cool released an article about a week ago with a bunch of spoilers in it. And this is on top of the fact that The Wrap released their own spoilery article back in December. The toys revealed a bunch of different character designs, including the full body looks at the Megazord, Goldar, and the Putties, and the movie's tie-in sequel graphic novel, Power Rangers Aftershock, is apparently already in stores, and that's spoiling a few things about the new movie and the spoilers that have already been released. It's like a spoilerception. So if you're like me and you're super excited to know about all the leaked info for this movie, then let's take a look at all the spoilers we've gotten about the Power Rangers reboot up until now. Before I do though, I just want to point out that if you don't want to see any spoilers and you want to go into the movie completely blind, then first off, why'd you click on this video? Also, spoiler alert. And don't forget to take all these with a grain of salt, since some of these leaks don't have actual sources attached to them. They were just sort of posted on the internet and everybody just sort of ran with them. Alright, so like I said earlier, back in December, we got a bunch of spoilers in an article from The Wrap, and they were all kind of generalized. I mean, like, none of it was super specific, not like Bleeding Cool anyway, but it still revealed a few interesting details, like the fact that Alpha 5 is, apparently, more of a helpful companion than his 1990s counterpart. While the original was able to help out as an extra set of hands when needed, you know, somebody that could help Billy with the more technical problems the Rangers had to deal with, he wasn't really all that useful. I mean, he got smacked around a lot.
Alert! Alert! Hostile takeover!
Sweet dreams, Tinhead!
Alert! 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 Alert!
Ah, that's better. Hey, what's going on?
Oh, yes. Wait, so I can put the disc in. There. Now do as you're programmed, you little robot.
Will do, Buckaroo.
The new Alpha apparently has the ability to transform his body into a bunch of different shapes so he can help out with a variety of tasks. What those tasks are aren't explained in this article, but I imagine they'd have something to do with helping out with training the Rangers, helping Zordon protect the command center while the Rangers are away, and being the extra set of hands slash extra brain to bounce the ideas around with Billy. Moving on, apparently Lord Zedd is gonna be in this movie, kind of, sort of. There's a couple contradictions about this, we're gonna talk about that in a minute, but according to the Wrap article, Power Rangers generally are the best of the best from the population of whatever non-enslaved planet they're created on, which obviously would mean planets captured by Rita nowadays, but back when she was one of the Power Rangers, enslaving planets would obviously be a job for Lord Zedd, right? It's also mentioned that Zedd once tried to steal the Zeo crystal, the thing that channels the morphing grid and powers the Power Rangers, but he got his face burned and I guess he ends up looking like the original version. The thing is though, this is a direct contradiction to the article Bleeding Cool released, where they claim that Lord Zedd isn't even mentioned in this movie, which, if that's true, I guess they won't reference enslaving planets or Rita working for anybody, but I don't know. On the one hand, it's way too early to bring in somebody like Lord Zedd into the fold as a Power Rangers bad guy. I mean, we still have to sit through a movie and learn more about Rita, Goldar, the Putties. There's stuff we need to figure out first before we can reach that Lord Zedd level. But I would like to think that Lord Zedd's being set up to be like an Emperor Palpatine type, you know, like somebody who could hang out in the shadows and manipulate things behind the scenes. So even if we don't get an on-screen appearance or name drop, we could at least get a nod towards his existence in this universe. Like maybe Zordon could mention that Rita works for somebody now or something like that, but who knows. Anyway, speaking of the Zeo crystal, that's apparently why we have Goldar. Yeah, Goldar was apparently originally created for the sole purpose of stealing the Zeo crystal for Rita, but obviously that didn't work out since there's still Power Rangers in this universe and because she's apparently trying to put him back together in this movie. The Wrap article claims that Rita has to steal a bunch of gold that she's supposed to use to resurrect Goldar via the molecules he left scattered in the Earth's atmosphere. It was also mentioned that part of that gold stealing will take place in an unnamed Russian bank, where the Rangers get to fight some of the Putties. Now that part's kind of cool, I wouldn't mind seeing that. Plus, if that's true, then that might mean we get to see the updated teleporters in this movie. And if we do, then I'm really, really hoping they get their own look, you know what I mean? Like, nobody needs to come out of that theater thinking they somehow got tricked into seeing a Star Trek movie. And that's pretty much it as far as the Wrap article goes. Like I said, there's not too many specific details in this one, but there are enough details in there that really get you thinking about the possibilities. Meanwhile, the Bleeding Cool article gets specific, and I mean like super specific. Like when they claim there's a flashback sequence in the beginning beginning of the movie and state that yes, Rita and Zordon were once the Green and Red Rangers back in the day. To be honest though, this one's not even really a spoiler since fans already kind of figured out that Zordon was the Red Ranger like a while before this article came out, and if the similar enough armor wasn't already a dead giveaway, the fact that Rita has a green power coin sticking out right there on her staff just sort of confirmed to everybody that she was supposed to be the Green Ranger one time or another. But according to Bleeding Cool, we'll actually get to see the two of them in full armor duking it out after she betrays the rest of the team before we see Zordon burying the power coins. I guess that means their fight takes place on Earth then, since the teenagers with attitude find their coins in the ground in a construction site as seen in the earlier trailers. It's actually kind of Animorphs-like if you think about it. The article also makes the claim that there's gonna be tons of Easter eggs all through the movie. It's awesome. Shocking, I know, right? Because no other reboot has ever had references to the rest of the franchise before. But according to Bleeding Cool, we're actually gonna get a couple really cool throwbacks to the original Mighty Morphin era of the Power Rangers franchise. Like when characters in the movie repeat classic lines from the show. Rita at some point gets to say, "Make my monster grow." No word on whether or not she has to throw her staff to the ground to get the spell to work though. While Jason gets to say, "It's Morphin time," which I'm guessing is gonna be before the final battle with Rita and Goldar. And Alpha even goes, "Ay, ay, 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 ay." We actually get to hear that one as part of a clip released by the studio earlier this week.
Ay, ay, ay.
There's also supposed to be an updated version of the original Power Rangers theme that plays over the Zords running into battle. I'm guessing it's the one we hear at the end of pretty much every trailer and TV spot. Which isn't bad. I mean, the last bit we get to hear sounds decent enough. I'm just hoping it doesn't turn out something like the redone version of The Touch or the Ghostbusters songs. And there's gonna be some cameos! Apparently Jason David Frank, the original Green and later White Ranger, and Amy Jo Johnson, the original Pink Ranger, will be making appearances in the upcoming reboot as some random Angel Grove citizens. Now, Bleeding Cool mentioned in their article that these might be more Blink and You Miss It style cameos, and Cinema Blend kinda confirmed that. They published an article a few days ago, and the writer claimed that they weren't even sure if they saw the two of them in the movie. So, you know, if you go to see this movie, keep an eye out for those two, because I know old school Ranger fans don't want to miss that. Now, this might all sound a bit weird and contradictory if you remember the time Walter Jones, the original Black Ranger, said that the surviving actors who played the original Rangers weren't contacted by the studio to appear in the reboot. Back in September, he stated, "Unfortunately, we were not invited to be part of the film," which is confusing to me, but I'm excited about the film nevertheless. Moving on, there's also going to be a mid-credits scene. According to director Dean Israelite during an interview with Collider, there was always going to be a post-credit thing. The only question was whether it comes to 2.5 minutes into the credits or right at the end. We decided to break the credits up and go 2.5 minutes in. It felt correct. And on top of that, we even know kinda what it's going to be about. He actually revealed in an interview with Cinema Blend, where he also confirmed the previously mentioned cameo appearances, obviously we're teasing something at the end that relates to Tommy, so it all sort of felt organic. Dude, if they break out Tommy Oliver or have Rita like scheming over him like she's prepping him up to turn him into the Green Ranger or something in the sequel, that's going to blow my mind. By the way, let me know in the comments who you want to see play Tommy in the sequel. There's also a mention at the very bottom of the article that one of the Rangers is gonna die in this movie. What? Damn it, that's crazy! Except, no, wait, that's probably a lie. There have been a few people posting online the past few days that they've been able to find full copies of Power Rangers Aftershock, and apparently all the Power Rangers show up alive and well in that story. So, false alarm. That having been said, there were set photos taken featuring a graveyard with the claim that there's a funeral scene in this movie. We also get a few other quote-unquote confirmations, like how Zordon apparently has ulterior motives in this movie. What those are, I couldn't tell you since Bleeding Cool even says that they kept this detail out of their report because reasons. If this is true, though, then that means Zordon's a super fast schemer. I mean, these teenagers stumbled across the command center and the power coins apparently on complete accident, so unless it turns out that Zordon manipulated them into finding both of those things, like he was able to set this plan up in advance, I'm gonna have a really hard time believing this one. And that's it, that's all the leaks and spoilers that we've gotten for the upcoming Power Rangers reboot. If I missed any, or you think some of these might be fake, or even if you want to see me review this movie when it finally comes out, go ahead and let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, I will see you guys next time. Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, be sure to click that like button, maybe leave me a comment while you're at it, and go ahead and click that subscribe button. Also, don't forget to check out any of my social media pages. I've got a Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, and Instagram. All those links are going to be in the description below. And I've also got my last video right there in the middle of your screen, so if you want to check that out, go ahead and click it, check it out. Alright, and I will see you all next time.